In this video, we plan to cover the top 10 360mm all-in-one liquid cooling units, which are going to be liquid cooling units that use three adjacent 120mm fan slots on your computer to cool down your processor. Before we get started, there are a few things to note. First is that we're only considering performance and noise level in our analysis, and we're not considering cost and how we're ranking these fans. In future videos, we plan to mix what is considered so we can provide the top 10 that matters to you. With that in mind, let's get started. At number 10, we have the Corsair IQH150i RGB Pro XT. This cooler is one of the cheaper coolers. However, it is one of the priciest per unit of performance of the fans reviewed. The fans are on the lower end of airflow with about average air pressure levels and are one of the noisiest. When considering performance relative to sound, it has one of the worst airflow and average air pressure per unit of sound with a smaller than average radiator size. This cooler has a longer warranty at 5 years and is RGB enabled. At number 9, we have the Thermaltake TH360. This cooler is one of the cheaper coolers. However, it is one of the priciest per unit of performance of the fans reviewed. The fans are on the lower end of both airflow and air pressure, but has an average noise level. When considering performance relative to sound, it has one of the worst airflow and air pressure per unit of sound with a smaller than average radiator size. This cooler has a shorter warranty at 1 year and is RGB enabled. At number 8, we have the ROG Strix LC2 360A RGB. This cooler has an average price. However, it provides lower performance per dollar than its peers. The fans are on the lower end of airflow with about average air pressure levels and are one of the noisiest. When considering performance relative to sound, it has one of the worst airflow and average air pressure per unit of sound with a smaller than average radiator size. This cooler has a longer warranty at 6 years and is RGB enabled. At number 7, we have the CoolerMaster MasterLiquid ML360R RGB. This cooler has an average price. However, it provides low performance per dollar than its peers. The fans are on the lower end of both airflow and air pressure, but have an average noise level. When considering performance relative to sound, it has one of the worst airflow and average air pressure per unit of sound with a smaller than average radiator size. This cooler has a shorter warranty at 2 years and is RGB enabled. At number 6, we have the Alphacool Icebaer Pro Aurora 360. This cooler has an average price. However, it provides lower performance per dollar than its peers. The fans are on the lower end of airflow with about average air pressure levels and has an average noise level. When considering performance relative to sound, it has one of the worst airflow and average air pressure per unit of sound with a smaller than average radiator size. This cooler has a shorter warranty at 2 years and is RGB enabled. At number 5, we have the iCUE ZoomFlow 360X Snow. This is one of the cheaper coolers. However, it provides higher performance per dollar relative to its peer group. The fans are on the lower end of both airflow and air pressure, but are one of the quietest. When considering performance relative to sound, it has one of the worst airflow and air pressure per unit of sound with a smaller than average radiator size. This cooler has a shorter warranty at 2 years and is RGB enabled. At number 4, we have the Corsair Hydro H150i Pro. This cooler has an average price and provides average performance per dollar spent. The fans are on the lower end of both airflow and air pressure, but are one of the quietest. When considering performance relative to sound, it has one of the worst airflow and average air pressure per unit of sound with a smaller than average radiator size. This cooler has a longer warranty at 5 years and is RGB enabled. At number 3, we have the Deepcool Captain 360EX RGB White. This cooler is one of the cheaper coolers. However, it provides higher performance per dollar relative to its peer group. The fans have a high airflow with about average air pressure levels and has an average noise level. When considering performance relative to sound, it has one of the best airflow and average air pressure per unit of sound with a smaller than average radiator size. This cooler has a mid-level warranty at 3 years and is RGB enabled. At number 2, we have the Asus ROG Ryujin. This cooler is one of the pricier coolers. However, it provides lower performance per dollar than its peers. The fans are on the lower end of airflow with about average air pressure levels and has an average noise level. When considering performance relative to sound, it has one of the worst airflow and one of the best air pressure per unit of sound with a smaller than average radiator size. This cooler has a mid-level warranty at 3 years and is not RGB enabled. At number 1, we have the MSI MEG CoreLiquid S360 Plus. This cooler is one of the pricier coolers. However, it provides average performance per dollar than its peers. The fans are on the lower end of both airflow and air pressure, but are one of the quietest. When considering performance relative to sound, it has one of the worst airflow and one of the best air pressure per unit of sound with a smaller than average radiator size. This cooler has a mid-level warranty at 3 years and is not RGB enabled. Now that we have covered all the top 10 fans in detail, we will cover the summary of the fans reviewed. As we look at a table, it can be difficult to see how each of them ranks among their peers. With that in mind, I've shown a bar chart for a handful of key metrics, including airflow, air pressure, and with the bottom of the charts comparing these metrics relative to sound. Additionally, we have provided noise level and radiator graph to make these easier to compare. Thank you for watching, and all the links to the CPU coolers are in the description below. And if you enjoyed this video, please remember to subscribe, like, and comment, and any feedback in the comment section is appreciated.